Dear Acharya ji, pranam. I once again went through all the verses given to us to study. They are about the praise of Lord, the holy name and the Guru. Last few days I had been reciting the name of the Lord. I had no doubts or questions related to the verses too. But just now I came across a video of my first camp, and in that camp I had asked about surrender and chanting the name of the Lord. And then I wrote down the answer given by you, Acharya ji.
Oh.
And within quotes, she reproduces the answer I probably gave that day or night. How do you know that that's what the Lord is wishing for them? You see, I have a servant. I tell him to go to the market and buy vegetables, and he keeps sitting in front of me and chants, Acharya ji, Acharya ji. I tell him to cook something for me, but he keeps sitting in front of me and chants, Acharya ji, Acharya ji. He's a very devoted chanter. What is he devoted to? Chanting. Is he devoted to me? No. How do you know that Vishnu wishes that you keep chanting Vishnu, Vishnu, Vishnu? Is Vishnu something of tongue and lips? Were surrender that easy, then it would have been something quite cheap, small. Just continue doing what you are doing and recite surrender, surrender, surrender. I had made up my mind to practice recitation or japa every day. But now, after revisiting the answer that you gave that day, I am confused. What should I do? What is the confusion, first of all? Parmeshwari, what I give is explanations, not endorsements. I do not endorse one point of view versus the other. I do not say that japa or chanting is right or wrong. I just explain what it is and I clarify what the pitfalls are. Do you get the difference? I tell you what a thing is like, and then I leave it to you to act whichever way you want to. So I explained to you that day about the pitfalls on the path of chanting. And what are the pitfalls? You become attached to the name and you forget that the name is there so that you are weaned away from your attachments. You forget that the name is a special construct to take you away from the world. The ego is very, very sly. It co-opts anything. So the old lady, the grandmother, had been chanting the name of Vishnu since 4 decades. And she became so inebriated with the name that she named her little grandson as Vishnu. And now since 10 years, she chants Vishnu, Vishnu, Vishnu. And a chubby little cute face comes to her eyes. And she feels that same maternal delight that she had been feeling all through her youth. See what she has done. She has defeated even Vishnu. She says Vishnu and remembers her grandchild.
So this is what one has to be cautious against. We are already occupied with nonsense. We have to be very cautious that spiritual methods do not become another kind of nonsense with us. And the ego is always prepared to turn into trash even that which is most valuable. Are you getting it? So, recitation has to be done in great attention. And what does attention mean? Attention means love and total love only for the total. Which means one cannot allow, one has to be super vigilant to one cannot allow the superficial nonsense of the world to clutter his mind. Otherwise, it's a very, very commonly observed phenomena. Expert chanters keep chanting and keep indulging in their mundane daily routine, which is not merely boring but actually sometimes evil. So on the lips are the chants and the hands are busy doing all kinds of rubbish. So what would Kabir Sahib say about it, Keval? Haath katarni. Sumarni. Haath sumarni, pet katarni, padat bhagavat gita. What is sumarni? That which helps you do sumiran. The rosary, the mala. So even as you are using a method to keep remembering the Lord, in your stomach, within you, is the great scissor that deals only in divisions. Right, Parmeshwari? So, jap is a great method. But remain cautious that the ego can possess it, acquire it, gobble it up. As it can do with any other spiritual method. Even the best of techniques have been rendered impotent, rather counterproductive by the ego. So, be careful.